गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स कॉल्ड साउंड। दिस चैप्टर इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज साउंड एंड वेव मोशन। हियर वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द साउंड एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ साउंड। वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ साउंड इज इट ट्रेवल्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वेव। So that's why in this chapter we will learn about the characteristic of waves also in addition to only definition of sound. So here we will learn about wave motion also. We also have to learn about type of waves. Now in this chapter we have to learn about the sound, how the sound can be produced, that you might be observing while I am speaking, it is producing the sound. What is there which is producing the sound and you are able to hear? Why you are able to hear? That is, if our connection from my side to your side is lost, then you cannot hear it. Means it needs some medium. That is, also while some medium, like it may be the solid medium or air medium, because while I am speaking, I am putting some energy or I am pushing the air in front of my mouth. So the air particle starts oscillating, and after oscillation, it is able to reach to you so that your ear can receive that disturbed air particle, and that disturbed air particle is perceived as the sound. So that we will learn. So we have to learn about the characteristic of sound. So sound propagates as the wave, but that wave have a special characteristic in which the particle moves along the direction of motion of the energy. So such kind of wave is called as longitudinal wave. But contrary to this longitudinal, there is also another kind of wave based on the same characteristic, means the motion of particle, called transverse wave. So we will learn about what is longitudinal wave, what is transverse. Also, sound always needs medium for its propagation. Like sound can propagate in air medium, sound can also propagate in solid medium or liquid medium. So wherever the wave needs medium for its propagation, that kind of wave is called as mechanical wave. But there is another category of wave which do not need medium, but it can propagate, like light. You might be observing from the sun to our earth, most of the space is empty, no air particle. Though this air particle and environment or atmosphere is only up to certain height, hardly up to 10 kilometer or 10 to 15 kilometer. After that, there is no air particle, nothing is there. But light is able to travel from the sun even millions of kilometers, and it is able to reach to us. So that kind of wave which can travel in a space without any medium is called as electromagnetic wave. So we have to learn another category of wave called mechanical wave versus electromagnetic wave. Then we have to learn about the characteristic of this wave. We will observe that certain characteristic always get repeated. So one set of characteristic or only one particular portion of that wave is called as the cycle. So what is the cycle? That we will learn. Then with the help of this cycle, we can represent the wave on the plain paper for the study of this wave. Ready? So it is this. So we have to learn about the representation of wave, then cycle of wave, and various other characteristics like frequency, time period, amplitude, wavelength, then what is the speed of wave, pitch and quality of sound wave. Then the wave can also reflect, like you might have heard that light is being get reflected. And practically we are observing, if you are taking the mirror and orienting it from the light source to the other, then you are observing, say from the sun, and if you are orienting the mirror to the other, then the light get reflected in the other direction from the sun. So that is called as the reflection. So reflection is also possible for the sound wave. So what is this reflection? Because of this reflection, we are able to hear our own sound while we are speaking in a very large building, or while we are standing in front of a mountain at certain distance and we are speaking, then we are observing that the same sound we are able to hear. That is because of this reflection. And hearing the same sound is called as echo. So we have to learn about the echo and reflection. Lastly, if this echo is occurring multiple times so that we cannot perceive what is being spoken, that condition, like cacophony, is called as reverberation. So we also have to learn about reverberation. Another application of reflection is that, so based on this reflection, we are able to measure the depth of sea, which cannot be measured directly with the help of our meter or inchi tape or anything. So that technique is called as sonar. So we have to learn about sound wave navigation and ranging. What is this sonar? Then the last one, about our ear and a structure of ear, how we are able to perceive or hear our sound. So this is the chapter outline. Now let us start with the sound and each and every topic in more detail. Students, let us start with this sound. Everyone is familiar with the term like sound. Like I am speaking, you are able to listen. It means I am producing some sound and you are receiving that sound. But when it comes to define this sound, what is this sound? A student, defining sound, we must understand that sound is a form of energy which gives us the sensation of hearing. So keep in mind, sound is what? Like light, it is also one form of energy. Like heat, it is also one form of energy. There are various forms of energy, and what is energy, that we have learned in our previous chapter. Get it? So it is same energy, but this have the sound wave or sound energy have the characteristic which enable us to hear. And this sound wave or sound energy have the characteristic that it travel in the form of waves. Ready? So what all these things that we are going to define. So right, sound is what? It is a form of energy which enables us to hear, or which gives the sensation of hearing to our ear, which gives us sensation, means our sense of hearing, by our ear. Get it? It's so simple kind of thing. So student, you have to must keep in mind, sound, if it is asked what is sound, so sound is a form of energy, the very first thing that you have to keep in mind. What is its purpose? It gives the sensation of hearing. How this hearing is done? By means of the ear of the organism. Or ear is like the receiver for our sound. Okay? It is this one. Now, how this sound and what are the various properties of sound, that we have to write. So regarding the property, it is traveling from one point to another point in the form of wave. Now, this sound is traveling. So very first thing is how it is produced. So we have to write What is the source of sound? A student, we have learned sound is what? The energy or a particular kind of energy which gives audibility, means we can heard something. So what is the source? How it is produced? So a student, it is always produced by any oscillating or moving body. Like I'm able to speak. What does it mean? Whatever the air present in our mouth or in my mouth, the tongue and throat, getting na? This throat and this tongue, it is oscillating or it is creating some disturbance for the air, which is just near to my lip, because I'm creating some energy from our muscle. Means from the my muscular or from my mouth, and that energy is put to this environment. Means whatever the air around my mouth, I'm pushing it outward so that the air particle starts oscillating. This oscillation is in forward backward direction, means it will move forward. So while I'm speaking, I am pushing the particle in front of my mouth. So while I am pushing one particle, another particle or air particle is here. So while this will move forward, it will push it. Another particle is here, it will push this. Another particle is here, it will push this. This way, it starts propagating around my mouth or around this source. So what is the source here? The source is my mouth. What the mouth or what the source is basically doing? It is creating a disturbance in the medium. Like in air medium, but it may be possible for the water medium also, or may be possible for the solid medium also. Getting a student? So the source of sound is what? Any oscillating body can produce sound. Like if you are just touching any of the two things, say if you are just, even if you are oscillating a single thing, that also produces sound, but our ear is not able to hear. But when it is moved very fastly, then you are able to hear the hiss sound. Ready? Why? Because while this is moving, it is pushing the air particle in contact with this. That will again push the other air particle, and ultimately that air particle is able to reach to us. The other way, while we are hitting one particle with the to the or over the other, then we are able to hear it very loudly. Like when the bell is ringing, means you are hitting the hammer over the bell, so loud sound is produced. What is there? It is because while the hammer is hitting this bell, at this point the bell slightly get deformed, and while it is coming back, the energy which was initially present in the hammer, that is being transferred to this bell. And in this transfer process and gaining the shape of the bell to its original, the air particle just closer to this bell and hammer, that starts oscillating fastly. Cutting. And this way, what were the energy of the moving body like hammer, that is being converted into which? Sound energy or sound wave. So it's so simple kind of thing. So what is the source of energy? Oh, sorry, the source of sound. So it is the moving. So right, any oscillating, or oscillating means moving to and fro. So any moving body which is able to transfer its energy to the medium, they can produce the sound. Or so this moving body, or this is especially called as the oscillating body. Oscillating means nothing but it is moving forward and backward again and again. So it is to and fro motion. To means your forward and backward. It is forward and this portion is your backward motion. Get it? A student, let us understand. Example. So it is only the any moving or oscillating body can produce sound. Means any oscillating or moving body is the source of sound. It simply means. Example. Let us take a fork. Have you seen the fork or fork? What is the shape? The shape is something like this. Okay. It is this one. Fork you might be observing in your kitchen also. Chimti jise aap bolte hain. So take the fork. Correct. So it is this fork. Fork also have their own thickness or something like this. Is the blade which is in the U shape simply mean. Let us consider this is a fork. It is put with some handle. It is the handle. So this is blade or fork. So this is the blade or fork. These two parts are the. This is the handle part so that you can hold it like anything. So it is having one point and two blades like this. If you are just a start oscillating it, what you will observe? You are able to observe that the two blades may hit each other and it produces a sound. That is, so what is going to happen that we are going to understand? A student, you just move it forward. Give a jerk to this. Means while you are moving it forward. These two will try to move forward. Then means move it like this one. Then you bring it back. Again it will try to come back. So while it is moving forward, later on we will take it back. So while it is in the forward direction, let me draw in the dotted form. So student, while it is in the forward direction, we will observe that somewhere these two blades will collide and then while it is again coming back, these two will collide. So the collision sound or metallic sound is also produced. But in fact, what is happening to the medium and how we are able to hear this sound? For that, a student, if this new position which is drawn in the dotted one were not present, then what is actually there in the medium around this fork? There are a lot of air particle in this medium. Okay? So the air particle, let me draw this air particle by this thing. This is the normal position of the air particle. Means the air is filled everywhere. Getting no student? These dots are representing the air medium. So let us take this as the air medium. So this is the air medium. Means these particles are representing the air medium. Means in the surrounding of this fork, what is there? That is called as the air medium. So while this fork have moved to the new position, means while it is being tilted like this because of the oscillation that we are producing or the jerk that we have given. Means you are holding it, you are moving it forward. So what has happened? A student, initially when it was in a standing position and you were trying to move it forward, what has happened? The air particle in closer to this blade, that will try to move forward, and where it will go? It will go up to here. And in this path, there is other air particle. So this air particle will collide with this one. Correct? Now, because of this collision, this will start moving forward, and it will move forward and collide with this one. This will start moving forward and this will collide with this one. Getting? It is something like this. So what is going to happen? The one air particle is going to collide and push the other air particle. This way, the air medium get disturbed. Getting? So this disturbance is called as the sound. Getting now? So disturbance in a medium. Now how this disturbance is flowing? So this sound is nothing but sometimes it is also defined as disturbance in the medium which can propagate in the form of wave. So what is this wave and what is this disturbance? So student, here we are observing the air particle which is being initially in a still position, but when the body starts oscillating, then it is being disturbed or dislocated from its original position. That is called the disturbance. Now we are observing that this air particle, why it have started its motion or oscillation? Because of the energy that we are providing to this oscillating body. While the body is oscillating, it is giving the kinetic energy to this air particle to move forward. But a student, consider this air particle. Let me consider two air particles. This air particle have moved and collide to this other air particle, which is in the blade. What will happen? Observe carefully. You might have observed, if you are taking one ball at rest and in collision we have learned, if there is another ball, it is going to hit this ball, then what is going to happen? It is possible that this ball, means which was here, it will start its speed in forward direction. But whatever the ball at the collision, it is possible that either it will just totally come back or its speed is being slowed down, that we have observed in the collision. So the same phenomena of collision is occurring between this air particle. Now, after this collision, what is happening? So whatever the energy present or momentum present with the first particle, that is being transferred to the second particle. That may be slightly reduced, need not be exact transfer. You will learn in higher standard, if it is the inelastic collision, there is loss of energy also. So student, this way, whatever the energy which was present with this first particle, it is being transferred to the second particle, and the second particle gains the energy E2. While the first particle, either its energy is reduced, or even without motion of the first particle, the energy is transferred to the second particle, and second particle will again hit the third particle, and the energy is transferred to the third particle. This way, a continuous transfer of energy is taking place. So, student, let us see like this. Let us consider like this. So let us consider this is the particle 1 which have the energy E, the air particle that I am considering. This is the other particle. It will heat this one. Why this have heat? Where this energy is coming? Because of the oscillation of this fork. So this E1 or the particle 1 have gained some energy and it will heat the particle 2. So after some time, this particle 2 will start moving and it will hit the particle 3, so the E2. After some time, while this 2 will hit this 3, the energy is transferred to this third particle because it's come into motion, means kinetic energy is gained by the third particle, and this have the energy, let us call this as E3. If the fourth particle is there, then while this is colliding, it will gain the energy E4. Student, this way what we are getting, the energy E is being transferred from here to here, here to here, from one particle to another. But where the particle one have gone? Student, if you are observing carefully, you might be observing that the particle one was initially at this location, and after hitting the particle 2, it will remain, the particle 1 will remain closer to this one. Means once it will hit, it will come back. This is the final position of particle 1. So the particle 1 remain near to its initial position, but the energy have moved to a larger distance. What is this energy? The kinetic energy which is being given to the first particle because of the oscillating body, means which is the sound source. So this way the energy is transferred, means energy have moved a longer distance, but the particle have not moved that much distance. This you may also understand like this. A student, now let us consider the practical example. Consider you are playing a game of throwing the ball. A large number of your friend are playing, you are standing somewhere here and you are throwing this ball, means you are this one, or the one of the player is this one, he is throwing this ball, it is catch by the second person, getting, then again he is throwing this ball and it is catch by the third person, and again he is throwing the ball and it is catch by the fourth person. A student, where this ball have gone, this ball have moved this much distance, okay? So this much distance have traveled by this ball, but what is your position? But your position remains the same, but ball is able to move. In the similar fashion, the similar characteristic is of this sound. A student, the particle moves, collide with the other, transfer its energy, and particle remain in its original position. Getting? So this way of transferring energy is our sound wave. It's so simple. So I will write the other definition of sound wave. So this is the player. So here what we are observing, player didn't move or remain at its position. It remain at its position, but this ball moved to new position. What is this new position? Position, it is of player 4. Are we getting? Means the ball have traveled certain distance, but you have not traveled. So practically it is possible and it is happening. The same is the characteristic of energy. So energy is transferred from one particle to another. Energy means what, student? Tendency to move. That is called the kinetic energy. Getting, no? Moving body possesses the kinetic energy. So the motion or moving characteristic have moved from the one particle to the another. This way, the energy possessed by the first particle is transferred to the second particle, to the third particle, to the fourth particle, like that. So such an energy transfer is called as wave motion. So this mode of transfer of energy is called as what? Wave motion. So students, what is this sound? Sound may be defined as the disturbance produced in a medium which travel in form of wave motion. That's all. That is the other definition. Here we have learned this was the medium particle, means the particle of the medium by the two black dots here we have considered. So this energy is being transferred. The other particle is here. This same energy which was initially from the particle 1, it is being transferred to 2, to particle 3, this may be transferred to particle 4. So this is what the energy is transferred. But after transferring the energy, the particle remains in its original position. Like while I am speaking, I am pushing the air particle closer to me and to reach to your ear. But whether it is practically reaching to your ear? No. A student, the particle is not reaching, rather the energy is being transferred to your ear. Why? Because this particle is pushing the other, so energy get taken by the other particle, this to other, finally to your ear. Getting? Even my ear also of my own sound. Getting, a student? So this way of traveling energy, so this is what energy travel. So this is what energy travels or energy moves. So this way of moving of energy without actual motion of the particle. Particle is just oscillating or moving to its initial position slightly so that it can collide and give the energy to the other one. So this way of energy travel is called as your wave motion. Are you getting a student? So it's very important concept, because the definition of wave is always asked to remember, but actually the student is not able to understand why this wave, what the wave is actually. Wave simply means a medium, sorry, not a medium. Wave simply means a mode of transferring energy from one position to another. It's so simple. So just energy have moved, but the particle didn't move, but the particle have just getting disturbed at its original position. Getting? So this is what the disturbance of the air particle. It is our disturbance in air medium. Getting, a student? So the disturbance in air medium have just pushed the air particle to move around its initial position slightly from here to there, so that energy is being transferred, and but energy is able to travel larger distance. Getting? So that way, therefore, considering this disturbance and this wave motion term, the sound wave is also defined in this term. So write the another definition of sound wave is what? It is, student, write this definition. It is disturbance produced by any oscillating or moving body, produced by moving or oscillating body and travel in form of wave. Getting, a student? It's so simple. So this is the other way, where the sound is defined in the term of disturbance and in the term of the wave. Getting? So traveling in the form of wave, disturbance traveling in the form of wave is simply called as sound wave. And our ear is able to perceive this sound. Getting now? So ear have the sense, or ear is the sensory organ which can perceive the sound. It's so simple. Getting, a student? So this way we have learned about what is this sound. So characteristic of sound can be written now. So write down the characteristic of sound. So students, characteristics of sound. So whether you write characteristic of sound or sound wave, everything mean the same. Okay? Or sound energy, Student, what are the characteristics? So let us write, summarize quickly. So it is what? It is a form of energy. The very first is, it is a form of energy. It gives what? Audibility. Audibility means hearing sensation. It gives audible or audibility. Or simple word, you may write this as the hearing sense. Get it? How it is perceived? Perceived means received or sensed. It is perceived by ear. But we will see, all the sound wave cannot be perceived by ear. So it is perceived by ear in range of, what is this range? This we will learn later. 20. So sound is energy and it is wave, so it must have some unit, and this is characterized in the term of frequency, and frequency have the unit hertz. So we are using 20 hertz to 20 kilo, at the term k here, hertz. So what is this 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz? That is 20 cycle per second, that we will learn later, hertz to 20 kilo means, student, how much? 1, 2, 3 more zero are there. Okay, now over
20,000.
Good. So it is about 20,000 hertz. So in this range, if the sound is in this range, then only our ear can hear. We will learn later that the bat can produce a sound, but we cannot hear it because it is producing ultrasonic sound, means very high frequency, which is beyond this 20,000 hertz. So only this much range can be heard. This is called as audible range for human. Getting a student? You might have heard, dog is able to hear very silent sound. What does it mean? Dog can sense even the sound lesser than 20 hertz. It's simple. So this range, whatever we have written, is for the human ear. Ready? So it is the very first, it is the energy. It is audibility, or it gives the audibility or hearing sense. In which range? In the range of 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Simply, you remember this data, it is more convenient. Hertz to kilohertz. It is what? It is a disturbance. So it is also called as a disturbance or what is this disturbance? Disturbance is the periodic disturbance is called as the wave. So this, how it travels? Travels means energy. How this energy is traveling? That we have seen, that energy is being transferred from one particle to another without actual motion of the particle. Getting? So that kind of transfer of energy is called the wave energy, sorry, wave motion. Ready? So it travels in form of wave motion. We will see this wave needs the medium. So therefore, it is named as mechanical wave. And the particle oscillates in the direction of motion of energy. So it is called as longitudinal wave. So wave motion as, right? So this wave is, if we further divide this wave, it will be longitudinal and mechanical wave. Mechanical wave. What is the difference between longitudinal and transverse? Tomorrow we will learn. Wave. Okay, student. So other way of writing this. Here we have observed that this oscillating body produces disturbance in the medium. Which medium? The particle of that medium starts oscillating. Means the sound always near the material medium. That can be demonstrated also. It needs material. Or material means material consists of the particle medium. The surrounding in which, or the region in which this particle is present, is called as a medium. So medium for its motion. So if the wave needs material medium for its motion, so it is called as, need material medium is called as mechanical wave. So what is there? So sound is a kind of mechanical wave. There could be the other, like mechanical wave could be the wave on the water surface also. That is a mechanical wave. So sound is a kind of mechanical wave. Other thing, the material medium moves forward and backward. Here we have observed from this figure while we have drawn. The medium is moving. This particle is hitting this. Here I have drawn here. So this particle first is hitting the toe. The toe starts motion and particle once again coming back. So particle one is hardly moving. This and this means in the forward and backward direction only. And energy is also moving in this direction, in the forward direction only. So such a motion in which energy and particle both are moving in the same direction, means the oscillation of particle is in the direction of motion of energy, that kind of wave is called as longitudinal wave. So right, the particle of medium, here we have learned it needs the particle medium. So the same particle we are considering here. So oscillates or moves to and fro. To means forward, then returning back. Moves to and fro. So it is the way of writing. It is a phrase for forward and backward. So moves to and fro. To means your forward and backward. To corresponding to this forward. Getting? The fro corresponding to this backward. So the particle of medium oscillate or moves to and fro in the direction of, in the direction of flow of energy. Flow of energy. Flow of energy or transfer of energy or motion of energy mean the same thing. Okay, now? So therefore, the particle of the medium is in the direction of flow of energy. So such a wave is called as, such a wave is called as what? Longitudinal wave. We will observe later and we will learn in higher standard. There could be the other wave other than sound which could be the longitude. Even in this chapter will also like. So look, like if we are pushing the spring and releasing it, it will again coming back. So wave motion produced in the spring. So that is forward and backward. That is called as the longitudinal. So we have to keep in mind the mechanical wave. It is a mechanical wave. It is a longitudinal wave. This thing. It needs the particle medium. So next topic is we have to demonstrate that sound needs the particle medium. There are few other characteristics of sounds that we will also see. So our next topic, the other characteristic I will write later here. So first we are going to demonstrate sound needs material medium for its propagation. Needs material medium for its student moving is called as propagation, means flowing of this wave is called as propagation, for its propagation. Means the sound propagates from my mouth to your ear so that you can hear it. Propagation. Or for its motion. Or for its flow. Ready? Everything is the same thing. So how the sound needs material medium, that we are going to demonstrate. Okay? Student, I think if we start this topic, our time is already up. So in next lecture, we will start from here and we will see how the sound needs material medium for its propagation. All those things we will discuss in our next lecture.